Some functions inside the Windows API seem scary because they are very big. In reality, most of the parameters are optional, so you shouldn't be scared. Let's talk together to a function like this. GetOpenFileName is a good example. It seems simple because it takes only a parameter that is a struct, but if you take a look at it, you quickly realize that you have been totally trolled by Windows. The functions opens a file dialog, and I don't know about you, but I think that that is really cool. So let's take a look at the documentation. Microsoft suggests us to use something more advanced here, but for our purposes, it is totally fine. The function takes one parameter and returns non-zero on success. Let's look at the structure now. The first parameter is the size of the structure, as I explained in the tutorial 0, so we can just initialize it like this. Now, if you start reading through the other parameters, you'll quickly see that most of them are optional. For example, we don't have an owner for this window, so we can just ignore this parameter since we already filled it to null when initializing the structure. The parameters that we care about are these. The lpstr filter specifies filters for the file types, and you have to first pass a display name, then a filter for each file type you have. If you don't want to use this parameter, you have to pass this. Then you need to specify a title and a buffer for the user to write into, and that is it. Now, if you want these tutorials to actually help you and not just watch them for some quick dopamine, it is important to do your homework. Your homework for today is to make a simple abstraction over this function. I recommend using a function over a class for this. And explore some of the functionalities in the documentation yourself. I'm trying to make WinAPI seem easy, but in reality it is easy only if you start gaining experience using it. For example, the first two lines here are the incorrect way of doing things, while the other two are the correct ones. There are also some things that don't work anymore. So I want to try stuff here and experience the inconveniences of debugging the Windows API to gain valuable experience that will help you in your future programming career. And as always, don't forget to share your experiences in the WinAPI channel on Discord. See you!